Hey guys, stich-a-heart here, and next up on my evolution is Sylveon. As you guys may notice, it's not all flowy and prettyful like she is in, or he is, in the, game. I just cannot figure out how to do the bows other than the way that I did. And yeah. So, this is a Sylveon tutorial for you guys. It's one of the Pokemon that got top voted for me to do. Anyway guys, hope you enjoy, and let's get started. So you'll need pink, white, and some pieces for the eyes. I'm using these light blue beads because I think they look perfect. Go ahead and get the tail ready. I'm gonna do double white, double pink. Make sure your bands aren't all twisted up. It'll make the tail look weird if you have them all twisted. Double pink, double pink. I'm gonna go ahead and do a single pink and cap it very tightly. Wrap around at least 4-5 times. Go ahead and just loom it up. Don't break, don't break, don't break, don't break, don't break. There it goes. Okay, it's like my don't break. I'm like, please, just don't break. Oh, please, please, let's not break. Okay. Ugh. There it goes. Oh. Of course it's not gonna cooperate. Take it off of the loom. Now, my tail's looking a little, it's actually looking pretty cute. It's curling on its own. You're gonna go ahead and put that over there. And then you're gonna wanna do a triple pink, triple pink. Triple pink, and then a cap band. Make sure it's nice and tight, because this is going to be the top of the ear. Okay. This is pretty thick, not going to lie. So here's the one of the ears. I'm gonna go ahead and slide it onto two pink bands, just like normal. Okay, now I'm just gonna go ahead and put this aside and do another one just like this. So triple pink, triple pink, triple pink, cap, and then we slide it onto double pink later. Okay. Take it off. It's really, really fat and fluffy looking. Then I'm gonna grab two pink bands and put them on. No big deal. So I got my two ears. Okay. So we're gonna work on the legs. Double white. Double white, double pink, double pink, cap with pink. Now this all depends on how high up you want the pink on the leg. if you don't want it to be too high up, then just do one set of pink and then the rest of them as white, kind of a thing. Let me loom this up and I'll point at what I mean. So you could totally just do this one pink, and then you could do this one white if you don't want it to go up so high. Okay. So here is one of my legs. Alright. I'm going to go ahead and put this aside, and I'm going to do three more, just like this. I just did my other legs. Off camera, taking them off the loom, just putting them aside. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and put down a random band so we can start working on the face. I'm going to go ahead and put double pink down. Double pink down. I'm going to go ahead and grab my earpiece. This is my earpiece, right? Making sure. Oh, that's my tailpiece. There we go. I'm grabbing this. I'm gonna kinda reach my hook in. There. So it's like that. Pull. And attach. Right there. I'm going to go ahead and do the other ear, too. Alright. Then I'm going to go ahead and do double white. Double white. Double white. Oop. Double white. Double white down the center of the face. Okay. Gonna go ahead and attach from that peg to that peg, the eyepiece. So it looks like this. Then double white in the neck, double white going this way, double white going this way. I'm just gonna white real quick. I'm running out. These are actually glow in the dark, so this is gonna be kind of cool. Okay, double. Double. Don't forget to do that on the center of the body. I'm kind of contemplating if I want a long body or a short body. Go ahead and do one more row. Why not? You know, if I don't like it later, I can always warn you. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab leg set number one. I'm gonna do the same thing I did with the earpiece. I'm gonna go ahead and attach it onto that peg. Taking the next leg. Attaching it to that peg. Oop. Attaching it to that peg. And don't worry, I'll do a panned out view. As soon as I'm done attaching all these. So it looks like that so far. go ahead and... I'm gonna go ahead and grab right here. This is the tail piece. I'm gonna string it onto a single white band and attach it from that leg peg to that leg peg. Pull the tail over like so and kind of tuck it in. Okay? I'm gonna grab another band, twist it onto itself, and attach it across, then pull those pieces up and over like how you just did with the tail piece, but we're doing it with the other piece too. Okay, twist the band onto itself and triangle band it, and triangle band it. So from there to there. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and reach in the leg bands to the two bands at the bottom and just start looming up the side of the body real quick. Make sure you're reaching in the triangle bands, not around them. Okay, reach into that arm band to the very bottom bands. It's okay to use your fingers to move things around. That's what I do. Okay, like that. I'm just looming up the sides of the body, and now make sure when you loom the outside or the middle, grab that band and pull it up. Just work down the middle or up the middle. Technically it's up because and reach down to the bottom of the neck, grab those two bands, pull them up like so. I'm gonna grab the two bottom bands and loom up the side of the face. And then this one's the center. This one's the side. Okay. Reach in the eyeball bands. Grab those two boogers. Pull them up. Reach in the ear bands and pull that pink piece. Same thing on the other side, reach in, pull up. Reach in, pull up. Don't forget the center of the face or else you'll be sad. And your slip knot. Always good to do it a different color than the actual creature, so that way you'll be able to find it, because at the very top it's always full of lots of bands. So, I'm going to go ahead and pull them off now. Pull, fix it up. It's already kind of... got his little pieces all together. It's all ready for me. Since his body already kind of started going this way, I just kind of went with it. Start pulling the legs to a way that he starts to stand on his own. It will take a lot of pulling, especially if you have uncooperative bands like I do. I'm gonna go ahead and put, oh, it doesn't even want to stand up or sit up. Do something. Okay. You can always train the bands to do this. Does take a little while. Man, the sun or the light is just not being nice. Okay. So I cannot figure out how to do the band, like how to do a bow. So what I came to the conclusion of was I grabbed a white band and I just decided to, I'm gonna hold it on my finger. I decided to tie a pink band. This will take a couple tries, guys, because oh my gosh, it took me like 12 times to try to do this. 13 times to try to do this. Yeah, it just takes a lot of practice to try and tie a rainbow loom band for some reason. They're just like, they'll do everything else, they just won't tie. Try that. Hold the white band while I tie the pink. You know, just try and get it. Sorry if that totally went off camera. Sorry. So then, just tie it like that. And then I went ahead and just put it around her neck. You know? Like that. You know, maybe do double the band onto her. So that way it'll be tighter around her neck. And same thing for up here. I just went ahead and tied it around like that. I just tied the actual pink band onto her ear. It'll take a lot of practice, so don't feel bad if you don't get it the first time. You could always use actual ribbon. That's another thing that I found out that works pretty good. It's actual, you know, like crafting ribbon. You could use that for her bows. No, it's not exactly rainbow loom, but, you know, sometimes you gotta get some extra little things in there. So that's my Sylveon, guys. Or not Sylveon. Wait. Yeah, Sylveon. Okay. Just trying to fix her ears. There. I'm gonna go ahead and put some white nail polish on her eyes off camera. And so when I take the final picture, it'll look really cute. Another thing you could have done, instead of pink, you could have done like the shiny pink. You could have done hot pink. You could have done whatever color you want. I know it's not the prettiest, but hey, it does its job, right? It's pretty cute. Anyway, guys, if you went ahead and did this video and you liked it, go ahead and give it a nice big thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed already, go ahead and click that subscribe button. I would love to add you to my family. And thank you, guys. And if you have any more Pokemon suggestions, go ahead and put them below. I have a list that I'm working through. And, you know, if you put a name of the Pokemon that's on the list, it kind of moves the Pokemon higher up. So, alright guys, have a very good night, and yeah, have a craftastic day.